हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम वीना साहू, प्राइमरी टीचर ऑफ डेमोंस्ट्रेशन मल्टीपर्पज स्कूल भोपाल। होप यू ऑल आर फाइन। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट मनी। एज यू ऑल नो, मनी इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर आवर लाइफ एंड दिस इज द 14th चैप्टर, दैट इज रुपए एंड पैसा। वी नीड मनी टू बाय मैनी थिंग्स, whether you want to buy a toy, whether you want to buy food or clothes. For everything you need money, and every country has its own currency. Indian currency is rupee and paisa. So money is denoted in the form of rupee and paisa. We have different coins for showing the money. We have notes also. So let's see which coins are there. We have these coins: 50 paisa coin, 1 rupee coin, 2 rupee coin, 5 rupee coin and 10 rupee coin. In the same way, we have notes. Notes are also 1 rupee note, 2 rupee note, 5 rupee note, 10 rupee note, 20 rupee note, 50 rupee note, 100 rupee note, 200 rupee note, 500 rupees note and 2000 rupees note. In this case also we have only 10 notes. Now let's understand that what is the important thing in this note. You must be seeing that in this note there is a symbol in front of the number of the note, that is 200 rupees note. You are seeing there is a sign before this number. In the same way, before 500 also there is a sign, before 20 rupees also there is a sign, before 50 rupees also there is a sign. This is symbol of for rupees. We use this symbol, and whenever you want to write down the amount of money, you have to use this symbol in front of the number. Now as we have seen that there are rupees and paisa, what is the combination between rupees and paisa? How much paisa makes 1 rupee? So we know that 100 paisa, if you have 100 paisa, that is equal to 1 rupee. So in this way we can exchange our paisa into rupees. Now you can understand it with this also. If you have 250 paisa coin, 250 paisa coin means 50 plus 50. 50 plus 50 is your 100. It will make 1 rupee. 50 plus 50, that is 100 paisa, and 100 paisa is equal to 1 rupee. So your 50 plus 50 will become 1 rupee. So in place of 100 paisa, we can write down it as a rupee 1. Okay? Now let's see. Every note has a picture behind that note. One side amount is written and the another side there is a picture of a monument. Monument are the historical places, and in the note of 500 rupees you can see there is a monument which is Red Fort. Now moving ahead, there is a ball. What is the cost of this ball? Rupees 50. But there is one condition, I don't have note of rupees 50. Now can you tell me, how will I pay the amount? I have 10 rupees note, 5 rupees note and 20 rupees note, but I don't have the note of rupees 50 and I want to buy this ball. What will I do? Can you suggest? Yes, you can think in this. Now let me give you an idea. I can pay 10 5 rupees note. 10 5 rupees note, will it be equal to 50 or not? Let's see. When I will give 10 5 rupees note means 10 times rupees 5. 10 times 5 means 50. So it is equal to 50 rupees. So in this way, I can buy this ball with the note of rupees 5 also. I have one more suggestion. If I will pay 2 20 rupees note and 1 10 rupee note, then also it will make rupees 50. How? When I am having 1 10 rupees note, that is 10. 2 20 rupees note means 2 times 20, that is 40. So 10 plus 40, that is your 50. One more way is there by which you can pay the amount. You can use 120 rupees note and 310 rupees note. When you will give 120 rupees note and 310 rupees note, it will also make it 50. How? When you are using 310 rupees note, it means 3 times 10. So 3 times 10 is your 30, and 30 plus 20 is your 50. So in this way, you can again pay the amount of rupees 50. One more method is there. You can pay 510 rupees note. 510 rupees note means that 5 times 10. 5 times 10 means 5 times 10, that is equal to rupees 50. So there are numerous ways by which you can pay off the amount. Now moving to the next, here we are going to calculate the amount of money. In this, I have given you 120 rupees note, another 10 rupees note and 15 rupee coin. Now you have to calculate what will be the amount. How will you calculate? By adding. First you will add rupees 20 plus 10, that is equal to 30. And when you will add 30 plus 5, it will become your 35. So this is equal to rupees 35. So in this way, you can add up the amount of note and calculate how much money do you have and what amount you have to pay for your thing. Now moving to the next, I have given you some question which you have to do it by yourself. You have to add all these amount and you have to calculate what will be the total money. In the first picture, I have given you 120 rupees note, another 110 rupee coin, 1 rupee coin, 1 rupee coin, 2 rupee coin and 2 rupee coin. So you have to add up all these amounts and you have to find out what will be the total sum up of all these coins and notes. Now in second row, I have given you 2 10 rupee coin, 1 50 rupee note and 3 1 rupee coin. And in the third column, I have given you 2 20 rupees note, 1 rupee coin and 1 100 rupee note. So by adding the value of these notes, you can find out what will be the total amount of this money. Okay. Now, let's learn about a shop. This is a crazy corner. Crazy corner shop. It has numerous things. Many things are there in this shop. They have ball, top, toy car, and then they have books, pencils, eraser, chocolate, and biscuits. Banana is also there, milk is also there, lemon juice is also there. And when you went to the shop, you must be want to buy different things. Suppose you have to buy 2 books. Now, can you see what is the rate here written? It has written rupees 10 each. What is the meaning of rupees 10 each? Each means har ek. For every book, you have to pay rupees 10. Suppose you want to buy 3 books, then how much amount will you pay? 3 times 10 means 30 rupees. Now if you want to buy 2 top, then how much you have to pay? 2 times 2, that is 2 to ja 4. So 4 rupees you have to pay. Suppose you want to buy 10 bananas, how much amount will you pay? You have to pay 10 rupees. You can pay either 110 rupee coin or 110 rupee note, or what can you do? You can pay 2 5 rupee coin, or in the combination of 2 rupee coin and 1 rupee coin also you can pay the amount. If you want to buy 2 glass of lemon juice, then what you have to pay? You have to pay 6 rupees, because 1 glass is your 3 rupees. So 2 glasses, 3 plus 3, that is 6 rupees. So in this way, you can easily calculate how much amount you have to pay. Now, you have a homework where you don't have to use your pen and pencil. Without pen and pencil, you have to calculate what amount will you pay for 1 ball and 1 toy car, 1 notebook, 2 pencil, 2 bananas and 1 glass of milk. So what will you do? You don't have to write down. You will just think it in your mind and you will pay off the amount. And now coming to the next, here there is a trick. The trick is that I have only 120 rupees note and I want to buy different things. So what things I can buy? For that, what you have to do? You have to see that which thing rate is less than 20, and by adding the rate of all those things, it should not exceed 20. I have done one for you. One toy car, one lemon juice, one banana. Toy car cost 15 rupees, lemon juice 3 rupees 50 paisa, and banana 1 rupee. So when I will add all these, it is 19 rupees 50 paisa. So I can buy this in rupees 20. Now three items you have to write which you can buy in rupees 20. So you have to keep it in your mind that the cost should not exceed rupees 20 because you are having only 20 rupees. You can buy only one thing also, you can buy three things also, you can buy four things also. Even you can buy 10 things also. How 10 things? Because bananas cost is rupees 1. So, 1 banana cost is rupees 1, 10 banana cost is rupees 10. So, you can buy 10 banana and still you will have 10 rupees left with you. So, rack your brain and try to calculate what all you can buy from this crazy corner shop in rupees 20. Now, there is a cash memo. What is cash memo? You must have seen when your parents go to the shop. The shopkeeper gives them a bill. That is called cash memo. Now, what is written in that bill? What all things they write down? They write down first the number of things which you have bought. Suppose you have bought one ball. So he will write down one ball. You have bought five pencils. Then he will write down five pencils. Six toffees. He will write down six toffees. Now next thing is your rate per item. What is the meaning of rate per item? Rate per item means that for every item, what is the rate? What is the cost of one ball? Or what is the cost of one pencil? So cost of one ball is 7 rupees. Cost of one pencil is 2 rupees 50 paisa. Cost of one toffee is 1 rupees 50 paisa. Now, because he has taken 1 ball, 5 pencils, 6 toffees, and this is the rate of 1 ball, 1 pencil, 6, 1 toffee. Now, he will write down what will be the rate of 1 ball, that is rupees 7. What will the rate of 5 pencil, that will be 12 rupees 50 paisa. And what will the rate of 6 toffees, that is 9 rupees. And he will sum up all these amount and he will write down in the end. That is called total. So what is the total amount? 28 rupees 50 paisa. So how much amount you have to pay? You have to pay 28 rupees 50 paisa. So have you understood how we can make cash memo or bill? You all can play this game at your home with notes and coins, but not the original note and coin. You can make paper notes and you can make paper coins also. With this, you can play the game of shopping game. You can make your own shop. You can use household items and in there you can paste a rate and then you can play this game. What will happen by playing this game? You will learn how to calculate, how to subtract, what you have to pay, what you should not pay, how you will calculate the total amount of 3-4 items. So try to do it at your home and enjoy this game. Now moving to the next thing, addition and subtraction of the money. This is also very important because you have to understand how do we add up the money and how do we subtract the money. For that, if suppose you have two amounts, one is rupees 12, rupees 50 paisa, and the another is 13 rupees, then how will you write down? You will first write down in the column, okay? 12 rupees 50 paisa and then 13 rupees. You will put the sign of plus and then you will start adding. First, you will add up the paisa. This paisa you will add. 50 paisa plus 00, that is your 50 paisa. And then you will add 12 rupees plus 13 rupees. 12 plus 13 is your 25. So what will be your answer? Rupees 25 and 50 paisa. So this is the total amount of 12 rupees 50 paisa plus 13 rupees. That is equal to rupees 25 and 50 paisa. Now next is your subtraction. How will you subtract? If you have to subtract two amount, first you will write down those amount. You will write down 25 rupees 50 paisa and then you will subtract 11 rupees 50 paisa from 25 rupees 50 paisa. And for the subtraction, again you will subtract first paisa. So when you will subtract 50 paisa from 50 paisa, it will become your 00. And then you will subtract your 11 rupees from 25. When you will subtract your 11 rupees from 25, what will you get? You will get 14. So what will be your answer? 14 rupees. So by subtracting 11 rupees 50 paisa from 25 rupees 50 paisa, we got rupees 14. So in this way you can do the addition also and you can do the subtraction also. Earlier we have done addition and subtraction without paper and pen. Here I have used paper and pen. Why? Because the amount is little bigger and when amount is bigger we can do mistakes. So it's better to use paper and pen while doing addition and subtraction. Okay? Now, have you gone to railway station? You must have gone. Because whenever we want to go from one place to another place, either we use bus or train, or sometimes some people use aeroplane also. So here there is a railway station and there is a train. This train is going from New Jalpaiguri to New Mal, then Alipurduar, then Golpara and then Guwahati. Okay, so they have given you the distance also and the rate which you have to pay. Okay, first they have given the distance. The distance you have to really understand that they have given from the New Jalpaiguri means that when you will go from New Jalpaiguri to New Mal, it will cover 57 kilometers. But if you are going to Alipurduar, it will cover 175 kilometers. And if you are going to Golpara, then it is 366 kilometers. And if you want to go to Guwahati, it will be your 495 kilometers from New Jalpaiguri. So all the distance is given from New Jalpaiguri. Okay? And they have given the rate also. If you want to go to New Mal, you have to pay rupees 12 and 50 paisa. If you want to go to Alipurduar, you have to pay rupees 28. And if you want to go to Golpara, then you have to pay 49 rupees 50 paisa. And if you want to go to Guwahati, then you have to pay 62 rupees 50 paisa. So this is called rate list. Okay? Rate list by which you can come to know that what amount you have to pay for going a particular station. Suppose someone wants to go to New Mal, then they have to pay the amount according to this rate list. Okay? Now, let's calculate. Here I have written some thing where you have to calculate the distance. Suppose a person is going from New Mal to Guwahati, then how much distance he will cover? If he is going between New Mal and Golpara, then how much distance he will cover? From Alipurduar to Guwahati, then what will be the distance? New Mal to Alipurduar, what will be the distance? Golpara to Guwahati, then what will be the distance? How will you calculate? For that, you have to really understand that what was the distance mentioned in the list. So let's go back to the list first. What was the distance here? They have written here 57 kilometers. New Mal is at 57 kilometers from Jalpaiguri. Always keep it in mind that they have given this distance from New Jalpaiguri. and then Alipurduar is at 175 and the Guwahati is at 495 km. So what you have to do? You have to first write down what is the distance of Guwahati from New Jalpaiguri. What is the distance? That is 495 km. And what is the distance of New Mal? That was 57 km. So when you will subtract 495 from 57 from 495, you will get 438. So what will be the distance? The distance will be 438 km. So let's learn about the cost of ticket. Suppose you want to go from New Jalpaiguri to New Mal. And for going New Jalpaiguri to New Mal, what is the cost of one ticket? Suppose three friends are going, then how will you find out? First, you have to see the cost of one ticket. What is the cost of one ticket? That is 12 rupees 50 paisa. And when three friends are going, it means you have to take the ticket for all the three friends. For one friend, 12 rupees 50 paisa, another friend, 12 rupees 50 paisa, and for the third friend also, 12 rupees 50 paisa. It means that three times you have to pay 12 rupees 50 paisa. So what will you do? You will multiply 12 rupees 50 paisa by 3. And when you will multiply 12 rupees 50 paisa by 3, what will you get? You will get 37 rupees 50 paisa. So 37 rupees 50 paisa you have to pay for the ticket of three people for going from New Jalpaiguri to New Mal. Now there is one more question. Suppose you are having only 150 rupees note and you don't have the change. Then how will you calculate that how much money the ticket checker will give you back? So for that, what you have to do? You have to find out the amount which he has to return. What will you do for that? You will subtract the 37 rupees 50 paisa from 50 rupees. And when you will subtract, you will get 12 rupees 50 paisa. So as I have told you, the subtraction, how will you do the subtraction? First, you will do the subtraction of paisa and then the subtraction of rupees. Here you can see, the paisa is written 00. So, and here it is 50. So, what will you do? You will first make 1 rupee into 100 paisa. So, when you will subtract 100 paisa, 50 paisa from 100 paisa, 50 paisa is left. So, you will write down here the 50 paisa and then you will subtract the rupees. And when you will subtract the rupees, then how much rupees is left now? 49 rupees, because we have converted 1 rupee into 100 paisa. So how much rupees is left? 49 rupees. And when you will subtract 37 from 49, then you will get rupees 12. So in this way, you can calculate that if you are giving 50 rupees to the ticket keeper and you have to buy the ticket of rupees 37 rupees 50 paisa, how much amount he will give you back, and you can cross check. So it is very important that you should know the calculation and you should do the right calculation. Then no one will be able to cheat you and you will be able to pay the right amount and you will get back the right amount. Okay. Now I am going to show you a news. This is a news of Mumbai. Here what happened? There are some children, 10 children, they were working in a factory and they all are small children and police has made them free. Do you know there is a rule in our government that below 14 years the children are not allowed to work in the factory. Still these people make them work and these children are not able to get the education. So now when they are free from the factory, they are going back to the home and they will go to a special school where they will get the education and they will learn about everything of the life as you all are learning. Have you ever thought why these people make these small children to work? What is the reason behind this? Why don't they take the bigger people, elder adults? Why they are keeping the small children? There is a reason that they want to save money. How they can save money in this? Because when they are keeping one adult person, then they have to give rupees 85 per day. Means for one day of the work, they will give them rupees 85. But if they are keeping one child in place of that adult, then they will only pay rupees 20. So they will only give 20 rupees to the child. So for adult, they are giving rupees 85. For the child, they are giving only 20. So when you will subtract 20 from 85, what will you get? Rupees 65. So how much money they are saving for behind one person? In place of adult, if they are keeping the child, they are saving rupees 65 per day. And suppose per day per person, means for at one person they are saving rupees 65 every day. And if we are saving behind 10%, what will they save? They will just multiply rupees 65 by 10. It means rupees 650. So they can save rupees 650 every day behind 10%. Suppose you have to calculate for the month how much amount they must have saved in a month. What will you do? Just multiply these rupees 650 by 30. If 31 days are there in the month, then by 31. If 28 days are there, like February, then you will multiply by 28. So in this way, you can understand that how much money these factory people are saving by keeping small children in place of adult. So in this way, they are actually saving their money and snatching the childhood of these small children. They are not allowing them to go to school. And there is one more reason why these children are working. That is the reason that because these children are from poor background, their parents are not so much well off that they can send them to the school. So have you ever seen any child around you who is not going to school or whose parents are not able to send them to school? Please look after those children, help them, tell them that there is a special school government is running where they can get free of education. Even government is giving them lunch also, midday meal. So you all should know about all these things and try to help all the children around you and make them a capable children. They should also get the education. This is the duty of each and every person, and you small children can become a source of their help. So try to do it. Try to search. If you are seeing any children, try go and tell to the police. They will help them. If you can't do, at least you can inform to the police. So in this way, we can save many children's life. So children, today we have learned about coins, note, money, how to add, how to subtract, how to buy the things, how to exchange the money, how to pay in different combination of note, one amount of money. So this is not only for the books or to the calculating in the copy. This is for your life, because maths is our life. When you will learn all these things, you can deal your life in a better manner. You can do shopping in a very nice manner, and you will be able to manage your money also. That is all about money. Thank you.